So as we think about the persona, let's talk about how we applied it. When we were at Sensible, the persona was a really important part of how we were so successful and how we got so much done on so little resource. I remember when Andrew Holly came in and said, hey, we should use this thing called a persona. And I thought, wow, what are you talking about? And we talked a lot about it. I said, well, I'll give it a try. And we did. A persona we used was Ed Champ, which is an alias. And he was actually a manager of the designers. But he was a perfect persona for us because we got along very well with him. He was local. He was here down in Rhode Island. He worked at Hasbro. And Hasbro was a good, you know, designer of toys. And he was someone who communicated well. While he was 10 years older than the typical designer, he was young at heart. He really understood him well. While he was a manager of him, he was more like one of the guys. But he did have some perspective that when we asked questions, he could give us a more reflective response than some of the designers themselves. I guess the point is that even many, many years away from this, more than 10 years now, I can still remember this guy so well. He was part of our family. He was part of our company, even though he didn't work for our company. And whenever we need to break a log jam as to what feature it should be, you know, well, sales always wanted all the features and development couldn't do them. And so we'd have to intervene and say, what features are the most important? And we could just pick up the phone and call them. And it got to the point where we knew without even having to call them. The persona really was, you know, that North Star for us that got us all on the same page and kept us focused, efficient, and effective to produce what turned out to be an award-winning product for the sculptures in the design area.